own a ticket out of here. Leave. Do you copy?
Thank you. said that?
Stay where you are. Don't move.
What the?
Look for the intercom. On your left. My name's Atherton. Dr. Atherton. I'm the chief surgeon here at Sacred Heart. My men and I have shut ourselves in the ICU. Quite possibly the last safe refuge in this hospital. Maybe the whole town.
What? How can that be? What the fuck is going on here? Listen, Doc. I'm looking for someone. A real nasty son of a bitch who got here shortly before I did.
Oh la la. You must be alluding to my latest patient.
Latest patient?
That's right. A real nasty son of a bitch indeed. He was the one who crudely dissected those security guards you've undoubtedly stumbled across. But alas, I managed to sedate him, and now he's tucked away, as snug as a bug in a rug, under my complete control. Nobody will meddle in this hospital's affairs. Nobody but me.
Doc, open this goddamn door right now. That bastard's got an outstanding account with me, and I came to collect...
No, I'm afraid not. You simply don't have the authority to make that decision. As you can see from what's left of my staff, I, too, have an account to settle with this man.
Now, you listen to me. I ain't gonna tell you again. Open the goddamn door!
However, settling accounts seems to be your niche. So maybe we can reach some kind of understanding.
What are you getting at?
How should I explain it? Yes. As a result of this precarious and unpredictable situation, some matters of the utmost importance remain pending. As you can glean from the carnage out there, I can no longer rely on security due to your friend's sudden appearance. So I need you to handle it instead.
Man, you are one insane motherfucker.
Insane or not, I have something you want. What you must do, sir, is go to the west wing of the hospital. Room 10, to be exact.
What should I do once I get there?
Don't be so rash, Mr...
Walker.
Walker? Oh, how appropriate to the situation at hand. Getting there alive will be a big accomplishment in itself, Mr. Walker. Now you'd better skedaddle. I am not a particularly patient man, and my offer may be prone to expire. You can contact me using the intercom when you... Better yet, if you make it there. By the way, that technological marvel that beautifully decorates your delicate wrist, the one you clearly stole, will be very useful. Very useful indeed. Feel free to buzz me on channel 27. I'll give you more details then. Godspeed.
All right. I'll do it. Fucking fruitcake.
Sam here. Can you hear me, Doc? I'm in room 10.
Mr. Walker, what a pleasure to hear from you. Glad to know that you're still a fine specimen of good health. I can't imagine what you went through was easy. But the next step should be much easier.
What am I supposed to do exactly? I don't see anything.
Not to worry, Mr. Walker. You're in the right place. Although you can't see it, there's a special door in that room. Now approach the wall directly across from you with your DID. That's right. As you can see, thanks to that extraordinary device on your arm, classified materials. Now let's move on, shall we? In that room, around there somewhere, is the body of one of my men. A cleaner who decided to make a unilateral decision. What you must do is cut his right wrist and retrieve a small microchip implanted beneath the epidermis. A clean and simple procedure, wouldn't you agree?
Now what the fuck else has to happen? Hidden doors? Implants with damn chips?
Mr. Walker, I want you to listen very carefully. There are many forces at play which, unlike myself, you just aren't privy to. All you must do is do exactly as you're told, no matter how unsettling nor utterly unpleasant it may seem. Now hurry up and bring me that chip. Over and out.
Thank you. What the hell is going on in this place? Secret control rooms? Continuous monitoring of the citizens of Keen Sight? How is it possible?
Satisfactory work, Mr. Walker. Well played. I wasn't quite sure you'd make it.
Yeah, thanks for the vote of confidence. Now let me in.
No. No, 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 no. Hang on a minute. Indeed, you've proven yourself somewhat trustworthy, but more so, reliable. I simply can't waste such a talent. I have another task for you.
What the fuck, man? Listen. I ain't parading around your hospital risking my damn life, chopping corpses for you.
I see. But didn't you say you came here to collect something from my latest patient? Now that doesn't leave you much of a choice, does it? So let's cut the chatter and get back to the task at hand. First you do something for me, then I do something for you.
Doc, I hope for your sake that son of a bitch is really in there. 'Cause if he ain't, and you're riding me like a donkey, I'm gonna tear you a new one.
As tempting as that sounds, I'm afraid you'll just have to trust me, Mr. Walker. Let me assure you, however, that I am a man of my word.
Heh. So what in the fuck should I do this time?
I want you to take this key. You can use it to access the lower levels of the building. There, you'll find a door that looks surprisingly similar to the one your device unlocked. By now, you should have a clear idea how it works. Once inside, I'll explain the rest by radio. Have a nice walk, Mr. Walker.
since I started keeping tabs on that Ronald. It's driving me crazy. How can you hope to get useful data from a brain-dead invalid stuck in an unrelenting coma? I'm beginning to think that maybe I should be the one to nudge him into terminal dreamland. Well, if that's the only way to convince upper management to assign me a new task, then so be it. At this point, I'd be better off a vegetable myself without the slightest sensations of being stuck in this goddamn job.
Doc, I'm here. It looks like an archive of some sort.
Precisely, Mr. Walker. Keep the chatter to a minimum, though. This time you won't have to shred corpses. Just park your tush in that chair by the PC and initiate the archive self-destruction sequence. The process should be rather simplistic. That is all.
Hey, Doc. I'm out here. Now let me in.
Oh, my. Mr. Walker, welcome back. You have indeed proven yourself reliable. I must admit, I couldn't have done it better myself.
Listen, man. I almost died covering up the shit you people have got hidden in here. The shit you're a part of, Doc. I thought your job was to save lives, not destroy them.
Do not presume to lecture me, Mr. Walker. I will not be scolded by the likes of you at a time like this. It boils down to business, money, and power. All of which the company has more of than you can begin to fathom. But I'm still useful to them. They'll come for me eventually. They'll come for me because I, too, am reliable. And that is exactly why you and I have one last task to complete.
Ah, fuck you, man! Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice. Well, I can't get fooled again. I'm done!
Just shut it and listen. An acquaintance of mine, Dr. Kimball, went missing and out of radio contact while carrying out an important job. He did, however, re-establish the signal just a few minutes ago. From what little I gathered, we've only got a few minutes to save his life. And who better than reliable you to rush to his aid, Complete this one final task for me, and I will gladly throw open this door and invite you to inside. Let me reassure you, Mr. Walker, that I am a man of my word.
Oh, fucking hell. All right! But that's it! If you don't open the door next time, I'm gonna find a way in there, and you ain't gonna like it.
That won't be necessary, Mr. Walker. Dr. Kimball seems to have locked himself in the east wing of the facility. But I'm not sure how long he'll be safe there. So please, rescue him as quickly as possible. Good luck.
Thank you.
This is the place where I was born. Where it all started.
Thank you.
Doc, it's me. Sorry, but your colleague didn't make it. I found him, but was too late to...
Mr. Walker, don't dwell on useless chatter. Just check the status of the computer equipment in the room. Did Dr. Kimball complete his work? The screen for the terminal display...
What?! Listen, Doc. I am done playing your fucking dirty little games. All I've been doing this whole time is implicating myself in whatever the hell crimes you've committed here by erasing evidence. I do not take kindly to being blackmailed by weirdo fucks in puffy white coats, and I ain't your damn puppet! My role as your accomplice in this fucked up horror tale ends now. I'm heading your way, Doc. And when I get there, you'll do well to give me exactly what I risked my ass for in this godforsaken labyrinth. Doc? Dr. Atherton, what's wrong? Answer me! Fuck, fuck, fuck! is this?
Sam. Is that you, Sam? It's me, Sam. Please, come and help me. Hurry. Don't fail me again. Don't fail. Don't leave me behind. Please, don't.
No. This can't be happening. Not again.
August 98. As all of my written requests have gone unanswered, I'm making an official complaint in the form of this voice memorandum to the Hexacorps supervisor in charge of the AI-8 quadrant. We are in desperate need of more staff. An appalling number of OBE are being diverted here, and we're expected to do autopsy and dispose of each one. Not to mention file the atrociously time-consuming paperwork. Since the guys at the dam are always in a rush, why don't they just handle the overflow themselves? After all, they're better equipped with a more spacious facility than we are. I sincerely hope to hear from you this